So,
Another essay, the Dr. Sheikh Farooq Ali. Okay. Good afternoon, viewers. Innovation doesn't look at the age of the innovators, but at the content of their creations. Keeping up with the spirit, Shastra presents Shastra Juniors 2020 for children from classes 1 to 12, with a host of exciting events, shows, workshops, and competitions to kindle the innovator spirit in you. On this note, a hearty welcome to all of you to the inaugural ceremony and lecture of Shastra Juniors 2020. To kickstart our event, we have with us our Dean of Students, Dr. Nilesh J. Vasa, followed by our co-curricular advisor, Dr. Sheikh Farooq Ali. I would like to request them to share a few words with our audience about IIT Madras and Shastra. Yes, sir, you may go ahead, sir.
Yeah, okay, 1 minute, huh?
Yeah.
First, this. Okay, so good afternoon to everyone, all juniors, students, everyone. It's good afternoon. Good afternoon to right, our chief guest and Professor Farooq Ali and all the organizers. Right, it's a very nice right event. I went through the whole program. It's very well planned, and I am sure that all the junior students, all of you, will enjoy this program. It's very involving, certainly. But right, there are many activities which will right, which will bring fun as well as learning with it. Right now, I am coming to something which is slightly different, but I would like to just give you some hint about right in our institute how exactly our institute works in terms of right students. Right, learning, living in the campus, etc. So, just I'll start a slide. So, okay. So, I hope that everyone will be able to see my slides. I'm just trying to see. Huh. Yes, can you? You can see this slide, isn't it? So, see, our we are all from Indian Institute of Technology, Madras. And as some of you must be also knowing that IIT Madras is right currently the topmost engineering institute in our India, and since so many last right 5 years, we are all striving hard and right for keeping our institute at the topmost position in terms of technology and engineering. And our students right, they are joined after their GE, so after class 12, and they all go for various right topics, engineering, etc. What we think is we should make our institute as while learning they should enjoy. So it's basically they should experience the joy of learning, and that's what we are opting for. And hence what we have done in our institute, of course there will be academic, there is an academic curriculum. However, along with the academic curriculum, there are various other activities where students starts not only learning, but living with, right, and living and learning environment with the lots of career growth opportunities. What you would like to become, what you could dream, you can make an attempt, and there will be opportunities available for you to, right, bring your dream through, right? Then we also have various cultural activities which are right, and the, one of the very finest cultural festival is Sarang, as well as a very important technical festival which is Shastra. And today what you are attending is the part of this Shastra Tech Fest as a Shastra Junior event. And we also have lots of sports infrastructure at par with international standards. Okay, now when we talk about Shastra and Shastra Juniors, what we will think of, what generally we think about is the innovation, creativity, etc. So this Center for Innovation, which is known as C5 in our institute, is nothing but something like a student lab. Anyone can come with an idea and walk out with a product or some creative outcome. Okay, and for this, students have put up their whole laboratories with respect to various right types of products, technological or societally useful products, etc., have been right brought out with the help of right students' activity. It is this C5 is run by the students, and all the students, they themselves right manages this activities. They have come out with racing raftar right car models. They have prepared their own design, and they have right even brought out various products, maybe a robot, maybe they have participated in various national, international technical festivals. All these events are, and all these products which they have over here are all by the students working in C5 at IIT Madras. And as I can show it to you, there are not only right raftar, but there are various other types of scientific or technologically advanced products which our students are making, and they all participate in various activities, etc. And they are the ones who have arranged this festival, Shastra Juniors, and I am sure that you will all enjoy. May I now, and thank you very much for your participation once again. Yes, I have,
Thank you, sir. I would like to hand over it to Dr. Sheikh Farooq Ali now.
So Professor Basu, you can keep the slide.
Shall I continue?
Yeah, you can keep the slide, yes.
Yeah, so.
Good afternoon to all. This is one of the interesting days that we look forward from the Shastra point of view, that we wanted to interact with a lot of young minds of this country. And I also always look forward for this day to meet and interact with all of you. But sadly, this year we are unable to do so. We cannot have, but we can meet online. And it has also given us a chance to reach many, many more students, young minds all through the country. So Shastra Juniors, as it is known by its name, Juniors, is for school students so that they can showcase their talent that might be hidden inside them. If not, they can participate and learn new things. They can see various things happening by fun. So we all learn many things all around in our career, in our school, in our surroundings, in our homes, everywhere. This is where we show you that engineering can also be a fun. You have learned science a long time. Today you will see, today onward for next 2 days, you will see how this science has been used and applied all around across you in all the spheres of your life. So the team Shastra that brings up this thing is by the institute students. There will be nearly 500 students who take part to this. There are only a handful of students who are at the top thing, those who organize them. Pranav is one of them. And they have done a fantastic job here. I am Sheikh Farooq Ali. I'm just an advisor to them. I just take the whatever they're doing, I just take a knowledge of it and just, like this, I give a talk, small talks, they work, I just say. So Shastra is very young as, not as young as you, but it's very young. It's just 20 years. We started Shastra in 2000 and we're just 20 years. And we thought that through this year is really, we're lucky that we are going online. We are completely online Shastra Juniors we are organizing. And we'll also organize completely online Shastra 2021. In the coming months, that means in next year. Right, so the fantastic team has taken this opportunity as taken this pandemic as an opportunity to reach you, has few things for you planned for the next 2 days. Please make sure that this becomes a fun for you. Do participate with complete full encouragement from your side and make it as much successful as possible. We have many things today. We have a talk by Dr. Anadurai, who is going to give you a fantastic, to the ISRO's in and out. And then we will have a small magic show by, you know, some of your age itself who will show you technical magic shows today. So we'll start with that. Then we'll have a lot of different learning along tomorrow. There will be learning on coding. There will be learning on, you know, how to use technology for arts, how to bring out the thinking process in your brain. There will be small quizzes for you also, those who are very interested in quizzes. So this way, the whole day tomorrow is packed for you. And then the final day, we also, you know, we do a small, you know, competition in the final day, because we want a lot of you to come out to showcase your own hidden talents in the Shastra. And then we will have we'll end up with a small function with magic for you all. With that, I'll stop. I know it's not right to take a lot of time from you, because we'll be honestly waiting for your events. So with that, I'll stop and I will ask Pranav to take. Yeah, thank you. See you all in the events. Bye.
Thank you, sir. This event surely wouldn't have been possible without all your support. So before we move on to the lecture, I would like to thank our sponsors for Shastra Juniors 2020, Dare to Compete, the official online hosting platform for our events, Tamil Nadu Science and Technology Center, our knowledge sponsor, which helped us reach out to various Tamil Nadu schools, MySoul, the gifting sponsor who will be providing discount vouchers to all the participants of Shastra Juniors, and chess.com, our chess platform sponsor, who will be awarding a diamond membership to the winners. We request all the participants to regularly check all the Shastra social media handles for further updates. Without further ado, Shastra Spotlight brings to you one of the stalwarts of Indian space research, Dr. Mylswamy Annadurai. Dr. Annadurai, popularly known as Moon Man of India, was the project director and program director of the much acclaimed Chandrayaan 1 and Mangalyaan missions respectively. Dr. Annadurai has led more than 3,000 strong scientists and engineers as the director, ISRO Satellite Center, and was honored with the Padma Shri in 2016 for his services to the nation. Thank you for choosing to be a part of this session, sir. We shall now be proceeding with Dr. Annadurai's lecture.
Thank you, Pranav and professors. I think that today is a day for the young minds. The juniors, that's what we talked about. And accordingly, I am also going back in my memory land. I think today is my assignment is to go back in memory land and catch up with the juniors. And how I, as a junior, then I have grown, entered ISRO, and where I am standing. I think something you go back fast and make a fast forward for the next 5 minutes. So, to do that, I think I would like to take some few of the view graphs to do that assignment point of view, what I am supposed to do. I would like to make some of the view graphs so that you will know what I'm trying to do that. Hope my view graph is on screen for you.
Yes, sir. You go ahead.
Yeah, basically now you look at the many of the students, I think you have come and about to look for the transition period. And that is the point basically can be one of your turning point in your life. So I would like to take the turning point of my life is thrown beyond. Basically, this talk itself is inspired by a caricature. This is one Mr. Santosh Kumar Bishan, a drawing teacher in the JNB. And he's, I think, almost last couple of years, almost adjacent years or alternate years, is getting the international and national awards. I think 5 international awards yes, on today, and 9th or 10th also recently got national awards. And he caricatured, listening to one of my lecture, he caricatured like this. And this is nothing but M. Annadurai, myself. And he put it caricature like this. And there it basically talks about turning points. Okay, how the progress along with the time, an individual goes, and taking a cue from my lecture, I think he has put it there. So I think it's inspired by that caricature. I think today my lecture also is basically dedicated to that teacher to make you to be part of this. And taking that cue, what I was trying to put this, a general nature of a turning points in life. I think it may happen when I'm talking about here, even for you also, either for the until now or subsequently in the your career or progress will happen, individual or the nation. I think such a curve is possible. That means over the time, the individual progresses or the, organization progresses or the nation progresses. Okay, but now the thing is something like this. To start with, you would have predicted, depending upon his skill set and what is going to gain, everything, possibly each one of the component, either the individual, organization, or the country, maybe predicting as down the line, 20 years from now, 50 years from now, where I will be, when you think you will be end up in the future. This is possible. But there is what most likely, when the institutions like IITs, if you join, and there is a very good possibility for how you have progressed until then versus how you will end up, when we change, different. Okay. Of course, there will be some localized ups and downs will be there, but notwithstanding that, there is a possibility of exponential growth surprise factor, especially the juniors who are going to listen today. I think they may fit into this curve. That's what I expect. But though you predicted your life something like this, probably we end up like this, where actually end up in the future. But you cannot tell that time, I didn't expect this, that time. That means when you keep growing like this, how you will get along with this and you make this curve still steeper and steeper. I think that's the part of parcel of today's my lecture, because as I taken from the caricature, I was trying to put myself here and try to run the memory lane like this. Probably you will also try to catch it up in this situation. So when I put that things in the perspective, slightly different perspective, I have put something like this. Me as an individual, or even any other individual, such a thing is possible. That means the two sectors, one is a student life, another one is a professional life. Okay. And specifically for me, elementary school, high school, college, then entering a DISRO, these are all the turning points. Chandrayaan 1, Mars Orbiter Mission, and afterwards, when you're talking about post-ISRO also, where I'm there, and that also I'm trying to put the things together. That means these are all the individually turning points that probably will make your growth, your progress, a slightly different way, depending upon how you take it. I think that is the essence of what I'm trying to put that things together. Now going back, my childhood, just I'm putting the things in perspective. If you look back my childhood, how it was, I was in a very, very remote village doing my schooling. Actually, the schooling didn't have a permanent building. It is a cow shed. Under the cow shed, we are supposed to go have a schooling. Many places have written there. But notwithstanding that, there is a seed happened in my childhood itself. Follow the routine path versus possibly a different path. I think that is the one. Probably from there, it was trying to trigger, even coming from my village background, from our residence to the school itself, made an incremental improvement in young age. What does that mean? This is in the second standard. In the second standard, this is just a symbolically I'm putting, not exactly the same items what happened there, but symbolically I'm putting that. The second standard, actually my village that time had a big lake, nearly 400 acres, a big lake, and a few tens of feet of length, height, water would have been filled. But notwithstanding that, in summer, when it goes down, the fringes could have the clay, will be thrown outside. So now we will pick up the clay, and that clay we will be asked to make that. Like you are today, Sastra, you will be doing many things virtually. But physically, those days, what we are told is, it may not be like a Sastra, but notwithstanding that, that's environment that the teachers asked us to make. From the out of clay, you come out with your own articles, you make it and come. And every year people will make, and nominally will they look at their elder brother or sister to help the people. When we are second standard, not much we can do. So the most of them, it's coming from their elders. Okay, like a juniors, some seniors will try to show you something like that. So it's happened there. So many of the people came out with the articles like this. But me, I came out, of course, it's not a very big thing. It's like a moon, and the moon trying to show that and putting an Indian flag there. Okay. Around the time frame, Armstrong landed on the moon, and placed the their flag, US flag. Probably listening to that and hearing, because there's nothing out to see and seeing in the newspaper only, and listening to the radio. Putting together, I made this. And I think this somehow my teacher got attracted by this. And he told, this is the different from the mill of others. Yeah, something novelty I'm seeing, something innovation I'm seeing here. So this one brought me first compliment or the reward in my school, a 2 paise pencil. First thing happened there. Okay, I think this probably triggered down the line is concerned. And when it came out, actually, this is the, I told initially, first 2 years in the Cowsett, then a Mariamman temple place. Then when I'm doing third or fourth year, a building called school came. Okay, and just outside, then we used to have the playground was made by us. Okay, it was a very, very thorny place, and which we used to do in the playtime to make the playground ready as the school students. I think this is how it happened there. So this first 5 years of my schooling happened here. But notwithstanding that, even the school, we had an increment, whatever I told symbolically, what happened second standard. Similarly, almost every something or other in the world, different from the crowd. I think that's what I was trying to show. And that was being recognized and rewarded. Okay, so this chain of actions happening, something you do different, somebody recognizes you and rewards you, then next year you do something slightly better. Okay, so that way, first time I got a pencil, second year it became a pen, then it became a geometry box, like that it was keep growing. Okay, and then I am entering into a high school. The high school also, again, symbolically look at here, from my village to go to the high school, 5 kilometers you have to walk. Okay, and this is the road nominally everybody used to walk, and it makes 5 kilometer. But I found some other road, 5 kilometer, it makes somewhere less than 4 kilometer. Okay, a small difference. Okay, that means not following the path of who already people are following, something different too. I think this is another way. And then again, yes, during this time, I have to walk nearly 45 minutes, I have to walk, bare boot, you have to walk. And then I used to think, okay, then write something. Whatever I think, evening I will write, or the school I will write. So it's beyond the what happened in the school books. And over and above that, I used to pick up thing almost from the young age onwards. What class teacher used to teach that day, I would have read while walking or something like that. Even that means before the class teacher comes and teaches, I would have been ready what class teacher is going to teach. Okay, that means I would have not only ready what he's going to ask the question, I would have been prepared myself to ask question to the teacher. Okay, which I have not understood, which I had a doubt, I would mentally kept it there, and that I will be ready to ask the question, provided as a part of his lecture that question is not answered. Okay, that means, so this is cyclic thing, another cyclic thing. So almost all my classes, teachers who come, they will come prepared for my class. It's never ending. Okay, it's almost without preparation, none of my teachers dare to come to Miles Simon and others class. That's a very, very, very well thing that happened. I think this juniors can note that. It was my days, it was like that. Okay, and my teachers used to praise me also when I asked the question. And whenever they didn't have an answer, they get compliment. That is by both my peers and as well as the teacher. It is a wonderful, wonderful feeling. Then, yes. Schooling is over. Now I have to go to college. Okay, like many of you were thinking. Okay, then what actually I was good at, basically not arts, basically something writing, reciting, and elocutions, and even drawing. I used to be good. So arts was looking like reasonably well I'm getting, but I used to get good marks in mathematics and science. Okay, so that way the thinking is whether to go to science is the thing. But still engineering, those days engineering just coming out. Okay, engineering was just coming out. Actually, I was not even aware of a place called IIT was there. To be frank, it was a situation my time that time. But notwithstanding that, yes, engineering was coming out. And engineering, as I understood that time, India even today also, is an applied science. So science, yes, you learn and you try to discover whatever it is. But you want to innovate something, it is engineering which helps you. That means nothing you are losing, you can be in science, but you can apply that science and you can be something better off. So that way, I think even though I was thinking various ways, and even though it was tough those days, I think the whole of Tamil Nadu state itself, not more than 1200 seats are available for engineering graduate, engineering entrance, the whole state. And today it is nearly 100 times more, nearly 120,000 people it can take. But it was a different situation there. But notwithstanding that, yes, I had scored good marks in mathematics and science. Naturally, I had opportunity to get into this stream, and I joined there. Yes, when we joining, it is basically electronics I took it, because it is close to physics, which is close to my heart. and as well as something you can apply all put together. I think the again electronics was a new branch, relatively new branch in those days, and the whole of Tamil Nadu didn't have more than 200 hall of Tamil Nadu. We had only 200 positions. Engineering seats are concerned for electronics and communication. I think this is the situation. There are 25 positions in my college, and out of 7 colleges in Tamil Nadu, only 4 colleges had the 5 colleges had the ECE position, and everyone has something similar. Then after college, what to do? Okay, then you look at here, the software is coming up nicely that around that time. Electronics is the place where I had done it. Okay, whether to go to electronics or go to software or a new thing is emerging that time in the India space. Okay, it is, I'm talking about in the 80s, 81, 82, around. So whether to go this way, that way there. Today means definitely many people may think about this. Many people in engineering think about this. But even today, these options are sitting there. Even today, these options are sitting there. But that time, taking this option was somewhat relatively tough when one to take it. The reason being, ISRO was something like that time. Okay, ISRO, and I'm talking about 82, I'm joining, 81 satellite to be launched. That satellite was moving in a bullock cart. Okay, you can look at the status of ISRO that time. And do you know how the small rockets, how they're making? Can you identify who is this person? None other than Dr. Kalam. Okay, this is the situation of ISRO of that time. So that time you have to join ISRO, because space means ISRO only, nothing else in India. Okay, then yes, I joined there, because something different. I told second standard, what is happening is, don't follow everybody, try to do something different. And because I was thinking something may be different, maybe there in that, let us join that. But still, it's a Government of India organization. You know, Government of India organization, you can start doing the routine things, what others do. This is where salary is allowed. Even there is a saying, the fellow who gets a job in the age of 23, he retires that day itself. Because he knows it's more like a pension, he get a every month salary. Okay, but still, somehow, as I told, someone is coming part and parcel of me, something is to do innovation. Okay, but what to do innovation was big, not a situation, because you know, the ISRO was that day was something like that. So then what I did, I took it, yeah, I know that I told now in the class teacher, I prepare and go to the class. Now I joined a career. Having a kind of chair here, I'm seeing nothing is challenging is there. I really got perturbed. Now you can see the 3 months of my perturbed situation, how I happened to be in ISRO. Okay, so I got totally down. Then I wrote in a page note, this is somehow I'm feeling this is not the place where I expected. And I didn't leave as it is. Then I made a proposal. You think about just 3 months old. I just came up with a proposal, what really we can do. Okay, that means making a satellite that time was not possible, but why can't make a satellite in a software form? Okay, and so that means those days satellites, very, very small satellites were done, and majority of the satellites, real operation satellites were done elsewhere, launched from elsewhere, and we used to only monitor and operate. That is the position was given. And for that, why we would have so much of patience, you have to come to there. So something like that we are thinking. Then we thought, anyhow, one day or other we'll make satellites. How in the mathematical form, functionalities, and bringing your all the things together, why can't we make a satellite? And that satellites, we will get familiarized with that, so that at least that will help us how to operate the satellites, even though it is done by somebody else. Okay, like a flight simulator. Like that, I gave one proposal, a two-page proposal. So then, Professor Rao, of course, finally, I retired from this chair. He was a person heading that time. And when this note, he has gone through, and this Friday evening I'm giving, Monday morning I'm coming back, Saturday, Sunday being holiday, Monday morning coming back, the note is back to on my table, and asking, congratulating me, yes, you have done well. If you are ready to take the responsibility, you can do it. Think of just 3 months into ISRO. Think about it, okay? I thought something similar, what happened in my school, happened here. Then next, of course, then only realized really depth of the problem. I struggled nearly 4 years. Okay, systematic work or system understanding, all the things called for to make a real satellite, first satellite simulator. By the time I have become here, okay, you get by as a systematic fellow. This is what many places I told. Innovation is nothing but a crazy idea, a systematic implementation, it leads to an innovative solution. I think that's what happened, okay? So then, even though satellites were done by somebody else, now our satellite simulator, which is residing in a computer system, will mimic like a satellite in all functionalities. So by your command, when it's going to around the Earth, around the sun load coming, and power generation, thermal system, I think it will do everything. So these 4 years helped me, even though I came out as an electronics and communication engineer, I ended up in knowing for the whole of aerospace systems point of view. I think that's what really happened there. It's a byproduct, it's something like that. But today, this is one of the thing is the line of the ISRO's many systems and making how we are able to make the systems as fault-free as possible, as simple as possible, and as economical as possible, and as successful as possible. Satellite simulators playing a major role before really making a real hardware. And again, when we are operating the satellite also, we will make through this and we will do that. I think this is playing a major role even today, which germination of the idea came like, I dwelled a lot there, but I think it's happening down the line there. Okay, perfectly okay. Then 4 years later, I have done that. But now, originally I came to the space system, but now we're working with the software. Now, is it a continuum? Now the software stream within ISRO also, software stream is coming up. I became a team leader. I could have gone up because I've been one of the pioneer in that. I would have gone up that stream itself. But you would have seen that any comfortable path was not a path for me. By this time, I would have realized. So then I thought, I think software, yes, people will do. Let me get into spacecraft systems. Real hardcore system will go. And software also will be part of it. But hardcore system, let me go into. I think this option also came to me. Then I switched over to this. Perfect. Then now we started making satellites, not the satellites what we're talking about that. The satellites which meant for, they're really a theme-based satellite meant for remote sensing, communication, education. Like that, we started making the satellites slowly. Slowly making with the, of course, not individual, it is a team. Now it's coming as a team. As a team, how you can make individuals come just to you, how you can supplement and complement the people and make the systems better and better and cheaper, quicker. I think the things are keep moving there. So when that happened, there came another, like this it came, okay? So now we look at here as a joint fast forward. You look at here, 1983 I joined, that initial software satellite simulator I have done. So having done that, they appreciated, then they gave another position. They gave another position, like that keep on moving, okay? Whatever I told the first forward, this is the point where from software to systems I move, then individually every year, something you do, then next you will get recognized. Responsibility is given and followed by rewards, okay? Not other way. If your responsibility is given, do well, reward is given, and recognition is given. Like that, it was keep moving. My career path was never ending. It keep moving. And here became deputy project director, become mission director in SAT. I think all the satellites until done, from here, all communication satellites, I was the mission director. Yeah, every alternate year, it keep on coming. All the missions came. Then associate project director for the first education satellite what India has made. So in this come, then came 2004, okay? At 2004, another transition point. I just am getting only a few highlights into ISRO. How we have came into ISRO, how into ISRO, then outside ISRO. I think that's what my idea of trying to do it. In 2004, a similar one more situation came. What does that mean? ISRO was doing well, 1982 joined, 22 years over. And the insats, almost all the insats from number one onwards, and parcel of that. And it just keep growing and it's becoming a very, very comfortable job in sets. Okay. I could have grown, keep growing in that mode. But becoming more and more comfortable is an uneasiness. Definitely, you know that. But there came two opportunities. One opportunity is this being in Bangalore. By the time, number of organizations come and looking for the people and looking at my background, both in software as well as system life. I think very good opportunities came. Very, very good opportunities. Very in back in Bangalore itself, and but around the same time, another possibility of I can get a Chandrayaan on mission 2004. Okay, and these two are different from this. Okay, but this gives good money, but this gives same money but a challenging opportunity. Okay, and so much we discussed. So much by the time I got married also, me and my wife also discussed. Then somehow I decided I should take this. because this is giving one of the unique opportunity. If we make, if maybe big, if we make something big, I think something bright is well waiting for us. Why can't we take like that? I think I have taken this path. Okay, you would have seen this. I'm trying to tell how the turning points, that means at the transition place, your decision making helps one to improve. But how it happened to me, I'm telling. So at this point of time, at the people who are at the transition, just you can understand. Only for that point of time, I'm putting. I could give the lectures in various ways depending upon that. But here today, I'm taken this as that way. But now, yes. When I took the Chandrayaan 1, there is a project report which Government of India, anyway, IOS member secretary for that got approved, and that is a very very modest satellite. Okay, very very modest satellite. This we are supposed to do in the next four years, 2004-2008 we have to launch, and always my point was it was going like that. Okay, so then after taking this only, I had a bit disturbed, because to make this very very modest satellite, which previously already people have gone to the moon many times, and this satellite, what difference is it going to make? Okay, because relatively this is very very modest. Just it can show I had gone to the moon, but beyond that, it didn't have much of a capability to show what ISRO or India or what Mahesham and others has done. I think something is missing there. So what is to be done? Okay, then again same path. As per the project report, you make the satellite or relook at the project. Government has given money, but you have the liberty to relook once again what can be done. Okay, and that was redone, keeping the same budget what government has given, keeping the same schedule what government has told, keeping the same PSLV, which was PSLV only the large vehicle available around that time. GSLV we don't have. So still keeping the same thing, how you can improve upon the modest spacecraft to a system which should make our presence felt around the moon. I think that's what we have done. I think we have gone through a lot more incremental improvement in the satellite system design and the way in which the science instruments are accommodating. Very many things we have done. Okay, and then yes, finally 2008 we are launch also took place, and finally look at here. This was the satellite originally we are supposed to have done. The same cost, the same schedule, the same launch vehicle. We have done totally different satellite. It's full and full India made. What initially it was we should make in software satellite simulator, I think we have made a dream satellite here. You believe me, this is the first satellite made by India fully here, and got three international awards. Is the point of, okay, for the design and the science objective and how to accommodate the so many instruments together. Okay, it is having so many instruments, 11 instruments with having a 16 sensor. Never ever anybody has done even their nth attempt. We have done it in the first attempt. Okay, I think with a very very shoestring budget, okay, with our own people, we succeeded, and we are the first people to discover water on the moon also. So many things we have done with the same thing. It is concerned. The story unfolds like this. 22nd October, I think yesterday only the completed 12 years of Chandrayaan mission launch is concerned. This is the first success. Okay, now it has seen almost coming to the front line. That's what happening within ISRO. Within ISRO, how an individual also keep improving. Okay, and you can see, you may not believe, that day Kapil Dev's cricket team won against Australia in Mohali one day cricket. But notwithstanding that, we had more cameras and reporters in front of us, and we came almost all the national newspapers first page. This came first page, not a cricket team. Okay, it's happened first ever time. It's happened in India. So then, yes, but still, it's our ingenious way. PSLV cannot put this launch satellite directly towards the moon, because elsewhere launch vehicles capable of that. But we have to wait for such a launch vehicle for ages. Even today, we don't have a launch vehicle. We can put the satellite right away to the moon. Okay, but we have our own ingenious way. This satellite can be put only around 22,000 kilometers away from Earth, longer thing, and 200 kilometers here. But from here, we have our own ingenious way of incrementally improving the orbit and try to get the moon. I think that we have done Chandrayaan 1. And that's why October 22nd we launch, and November 8th, actually November 4th is given another incremental fire here, and that made it reach to November 8th. 2008, I think we reached that way, and then we acquired around the moon, and that way technically 2008 to reach the moon we have done it. Okay, so that way definitely what is supposed to be done as per the project report we have done, but still Mahesham and another will not get satisfied now, you know that. Okay, technology demonstration, just going around the moon, I didn't want to celebrate. Let us do something else. Okay, that's how it happened. Search for water, looking at within all the instruments. Nobody has, everybody declared moon is not having water. But somehow I had a lingering question whether water is it really correct. Okay, because the reason being, I'll tell you, the people all landed on the moon somewhere here. Okay, except this mission. This mission was launched 5 years later to us. Okay, and that is only to confirm what we have done is correct. But otherwise, all the people previously landed here only. But now, and then that means many places, unexplored areas were there. Without looking at all the areas, how people can tell the moon is not having water, and other side of the moon also not seen. So especially poles, nobody has looked at that all. So we went systematically, all the instruments looked at the whole moon. When looked at the air, yes, we have seen. You look at here, these are all the places where the blue is there, okay, hydroxyl molecules, okay, that is what we have seen. And into the poles, look at the poles, we are seeing many of the craters never ever seen the sunlight or that ice in the form of ice for various few meters depth, the form of ice water was seen. So this is the first ever discovery anybody has done. Okay, we started by very modest, but we have done, we made a difference. We were the 70th mission go to the moon to discover water on the moon. I think that's the remarkable difference we made. After that, back to the moon. Today, you look at here, back to the moon, a big way people are talking about, and to go to the moon, making colony. I think another 4, 5 years from now, lot of activities will keep happening in and around the moon, thanks to Chandrayaan's this discovery. It's happened there. But path is not very soon. No? So I told 22nd October we launch. But 25th October, by the time we discovered water and all, everything got done. Chandrayaan 1 communication got discontinued on this day. Okay. So then the whole team has revoked, and we came out with let us make it Chandrayaan 2 as quick as possible. What made this failure to happen, understand, correct it. With that, we went ahead. In 2011, we were ready with the Chandrayaan 2 orbiter. And by the time, we are supposed to go with the Russians. Actually, this mission has been worked out for very various reasons, go along with the Russian team. That means ISRO will make a modified Chandrayaan 2 orbiter that should work for longer time. And Russia will come to go in 2011. But now what is happening is, unfortunately, when we are ready by this time, Russia dropped out. Russia dropped out means Russia told they want to make so many corrections in their lander. Once you make that corrections in their lander, our Chandrayaan 2 orbiter, what we have almost ready, cannot fly with them. So this is a big situation. What to do, we don't know. Okay. And then it calls for even our GSLV could not take it. So it's a really, really big situation. The whole team was under perplexed condition. Okay. When the whole team is in perplexed condition, this is there. And quite naturally, you know, there is an opportunity for something to do. Okay. This way, that way, this way, that way. This is a transition another way. I told the transitions, the turning points, how transition comes. I was thinking, shall we make another mission or keep continuing as Chandrayaan 2 orbiter until Russia comes, or you make our lander? I think then finally we told, yes, we should make our own lander. But pretty well I know that to make lander afresh, it will take another 7-8 years, because the government getting a budget itself will take another some more years. Then you have to make a lander, many things. It will take time. Until then, what to do the hardware you have done? I think something we should do better. What to do that came? An opportunity has been identified. That means, you know, every year you cannot launch a mission to the Mars. For example, Earth going around the Sun, or Mars is going around the Sun, but once in 26 months, there is an opportunity comes wherein by you launch it around that time, you will able to, with the minimum fuel, optimum fuel, get the Mars. That's why every country, once in 26 months, they will do an opportunity. One such opportunity was available around 2011. Okay, 2011 end only that problem came. So we have 2013 opportunity was there. 2013 opportunity is a very, very good opportunity. We can do it. And that when you launch here, it will go reach there, 2014. There is possibility existing. Why I'm telling here? Here I'm trying to match the orbiter. What we have done is almost ready. The lander, suppose Russians have done, is not ready with you. Now you need an innovative solution. Innovative solution is, instead of going to, is it possible for going to the Mars? Okay, it's totally different way of thinking, because now without lander, if you go once again to the moon, the same like Chandrayaan only, instead of Chandrayaan 1, let us make it Chandrayaan Mars 2. Okay, like that with some idea came. So then we started thinking about whether why can't we go to the same hardware, go to the Mars. But the issue is something like this. Okay, before that, I told at least moon people have gone and they have not discovered water on the moon. Okay, but now here the story is totally different. And before that also, we have gone to the Mars. Okay, only 21 succeeded. 42% only success rate. Okay, not even a single country succeeded first attempt. The earliest is US succeeded in fifth attempt, Russia succeeded in ninth attempt, China had to succeed, Japan had to succeed. Now we are thinking a hardware which is made to go to the moon, supposed to go to Mars. Such a totally different scenario, okay, isn't it? But still, we didn't want to leave it. You want to understand, let us not worry about how they succeeded, let us concentrate why they failed. Okay, I'm trying to still innovation various perspective. I'm not trying to put the innovation like from the initial how I got pencil onwards. Innovation is sitting there, just I'm putting the things together. So instead of not bothering about their how success, we are looking at what is the fail, why they failed listed out. And is it possible what we can do on that? Okay, that is the situation. So that is how the transition came. Yes, as usual, they are looking at here. So many times people have failed. So let us not go to the moon. I can drop the Mars mission, wait for Chandrayaan 2, take another 7-8 years. So, as I told, Mars mission experience by others. Why they failed? If you learn why they failed and try to not to make that failure in our mission, we can succeed. One thing. Second thing is, in Chandrayaan 1 also, we had a good experience of first attempt PSLV cell reaching. But we had only one problem of within 1 year, the mission short-lived within 1 year. Okay, that alone, if you correct it, because there, when we carry on so many instruments, we over optimize the whole system. I think that is one of the reasons why our failure came. We understood that and can correct it, and as we have done that way. That means you combine A and B. That means why the people have failed, ensure that you don't fail in that mode. Second thing is what Chandrayaan 1 experience, both plus and minus, everything you take together, and ensure the plus, retain the plus. Make it a plus. That means why they failed, that you try to correct it. All put together, I think somehow I felt we can go for success. I think the whole management also got convinced. I think we could make it. But by the time, we had only 11 months to go to the Mars. Okay, this is something peculiar situation. And normally the people I told 51 times they were gone. Not every country almost take an average 6 to 7 years to make a hardware. Fresh hardware. But we have made a hardware which is going to the moon. But now we have to modify it, go to the Mars. And we have only 11 months available. It's really, really a tricky situation. But still, yes, I think we have done it. Because our experience of Chandrayaan 1 is there. Same, whatever I have done there. But from here to here, we have 9 months. And the software, we are good. And what is called for software modification, we can do even during 9 months. I think we have taken a very, very robust way they have taken. So that way, very, very simple hardware, which is supposed to go to here. And finally, we are supposed to throw it, go to the moon. Instead of throw it with slightly higher velocity, such that from this velocity, it escapes our Earth gravity and falls into the something called heliocentric sphere. That means it falls under the gravity of the sun and will go follow the orbit around the sun as if Earth is going, as if Mars is going. But in a such a direction, such a speed, such that after 9 months, when it come over here, Mars supposed to us here, which is moving around here with a nearly 24, 25 kilometer every second. Okay, when it reaches here, you are supposed to be there within some few kilometers away. Okay, 500 kilometer plus minus few kilometers. That is the preciseness you have to reach there. Once you do that, then you do a small maneuver autonomously. For that required software would have uploaded here. That autonomously will do that operation here and will get captured by Mars. Okay, that's what it's supposed to do. And that's what you have to plan like that. So this is what, with that aim, I think we went at this mission. And just I will run the simulation, what we have done. And exactly we followed that simulation thing. And where we expected each day versus where it is there, we used to look at that and accordingly correct it and ensure this mission is getting success after 9 months of its endurance journey. And exactly like Chandrayaan 1, what we have done. Okay. Now, an incremental improvement last thing, yeah, now if you give a big kick, it goes outside the Earth's gravity field and it enters into the sun gravity. Now Earth, Mars and our own satellite, man-made satellite, all three are going around the sun. Okay, and we will be watching here every day. It's keep running. I think now we told that keep watching against that. Any deviation is there. Any deviation is there or small correction, very, very small correction. Otherwise, it goes on its own with not much of a fuel being spent there. It's simply a natural follow like any planetary body. Yeah, it goes there. It subsequent year, September, it reaches there. Now our prime minister was gone behind the Mars and we acquired it. Okay, when we did, India was the first ever country in a first attempt itself to succeed around the Mars. Okay, with the very, very modest. And again, this mission was not planned to go to the Mars. Okay, but we have done it. Okay, we have done it. There's something marvelous. Never ever anybody believed India could make it. Okay, I think that's what we have done there. Yes, as I told, no, every time something you do, you will get something. So after the Mars, I got the director's position. This is what I told Professor Yuara was sitting, that position. Of course, now I got a bigger, much bigger room than what you are sitting also. Okay. And this is the director ISRO Satellite Center, I became. Okay. And you can see that this photo is now behind me, symbolically behind me, you can see that. Dr. Kalam, one of the times when you are visiting his camp. So now, from this position to this position, how it came is purely you tell something, people recognized you and asked you to do something like that. That's the cascading way that the ladder has gone up and up and up. Now, once you come to this position, it's a government of India job. Everything is with you. I think you can enjoy the life. That is possible now. But again, transition. Again, looking for which way to go. Okay. Either status quo. You maintain by the time every 3 years, 4 years, some satellite being launched, once in a while, one Chandrayaan, Mangalyaan launch coming. Okay, you can enjoy the life. The media is coming. Everything you can do perfectly. Life can be enjoyed. But somehow I didn't want to take this status quo route. Okay. Something new initiative we should do. What to do with the new position, a new opening, something we should do. So that is basically trying to build the ISRO in a much, much better perspective. Okay. Bringing so much of infrastructure, such that once upon a time, once in 4 years, one satellite was launched. Now I made a tail, I made a point, I made it proclaimed like our software satellite simulator we should do like that. Instead of every 4 years on satellite, why can't we make every 4 weeks on satellite? I think you're totally, totally different. Not only told, done it. Okay. The 2015 to 2018, 30 satellites were launched in 36 months. Okay. First 2-3 months, I would have talked, but require infrastructure, everything was built. And the satellites are not simple satellite, not the satellite what we've seen initially. Today, the satellites are such a powerful, nearly what a power it can handle, 6 tonner weight. Okay. And anywhere in India, it's possible to have your handheld phone to talk. Very many things are happening. Meteorological point of view, navigational point of view, very many sophisticated satellites. Number, quantity, and quality both improved. And huge infrastructure. Okay. When I entered, I was shown you how autos infrastructure. Today, India is having one of the finest infrastructure for aerospace in Bangalore, be it in Sirigarikota, this. Even outside people envy about our facilities today. Okay. And simultaneously, we can make 22 satellites can be integrated simultaneously. Okay. That is the situation. It is ISRO has come. That's how. And now today, you look at here, Government of India has told, private companies also can make use of this facility so that manpower enrichment beyond even ISRO can come and work here. That has enabled that thing. This is one such meeting where private companies were brought here and shown to the people, yes, you also can come and work with our people. So that means within Government of India, an ecosystem of competitive ecosystem. Some of the clean rooms exclusively meant for private industry, some for ISRO, and whomever makes faster, better, cheaper, that flies. I think that is the competition we enabled within ISRO. Okay, and thus everything is going. And yes, once again, our Padma Shri award also came. Something you do, our recognition also happens. No? That also going unperturbed. That also is gone through that way. And then I got an opportunity to showcase our India's capabilities. And chairing 87 countries forum in UN for the peaceful use of outer space. A forum was there In that, I had an opportunity to chair for 3 years. I think that's also happened to that in the process. Okay. And the professionally, we are increasing. But still, Government of India, one day you will retire. Okay. After 36 years, superannuation. I think this is, I don't think say anybody within this role got such a thing and spontaneously. Okay. Because only I was thinking I will get some additional years to continue, but somehow it didn't happen. So spontaneously, that last day, I think gathered. And as far as I am concerned, an unprecedented farewell happened within ISRO. Perfect. Next day, again, same road. Okay. The pensioner's life, Government of India, pensioner's life looking so barren. Okay. And I all along was so occupied. Okay. From my school days to that, you would have seen the call occupied. How to go? This was really a tough situation. Okay. This may be straight path in Bangalore. Your house is there. A very nice thing. Pension also reasonably good pension. I think one of the highest pension I am getting from Government of India. But I could have taken a like this. But still, somehow I was not feeling comfortable. So then good number of positions in private establishments came. But another thing is S&T projects also probably I myself can. Something like that was thinking was going on. Then by the time we look at here, what happened elsewhere? Okay, I am there in the 10th standard science book since 2009. In school notebooks and refers, many of the school children are seeing. Actually, in school compounds in Tamil Nadu also, you could have seen many places like this. Looking at all these things, I thought beyond money, something I should do. Okay. So then I went, I think I went around the India. Okay. Many places met the people, meeting young scientists and students. I think you have very good opportunity. Basically, what I was telling is, without any background I have done, purely because of education, purely because of opportunities given in India, I could come up. Okay. I went to US only after Chandrayaan making and water on the moon. Before that, I didn't go. Okay. Everything was done within India. We have done it. Having done that, I think such opportunity probably use it cash on today, because we came from very scratch. Okay, you have very good opportunities. I think today, if you do it, India do wonders in the world. Opportunity, please don't lose it. Okay. Once you lose it, then getting back is difficult. America is struggling today. Once upon a time, they landed on the moon. Many things they have done. Now, today, they're struggling to go back to the moon. I know. Okay. And that should not happen there. So you cash on this. I think you do it as much possible. This I was participating to the young scientists and students. I think I have done many things as best possible. And then I'm writing so many books also, mostly from local language, and a good number of books also I've written there. And still, now COVID has come. I cannot keep going around. Going around is not possible today. And now sit idle, that's one possibility. But opportunity due to COVID. COVID also gives some opportunity. That's what I thought. Okay, what is that opportunity? Now, as I'm talking to you, but not only talking to you, okay? I almost every day, 2 or 3 webinars I'm having, meeting with center, state policymakers, entrepreneurs, engineering professionals, scientists, teachers, and students like you, okay? In the lockdown, I'm doing almost day in, day out doing, and thanks Pranav and the team has given me the opportunity to talk with you also, to convey my thinking of, yes, I have gone and I owe to this country, which gave me such a wonderful opportunity. And you also can do it. I think that's the thing I was trying to tell. Somehow we came, but you have a good opportunity to do. So look at here. This is Tamil Nadu Planning Commission. I am through webinar mode, I'm reaching. Okay. We are discussing many things. Scientists, I'm talking. Very many things we are talking. This is from central minister we are talking about. What we are talking about? Just giving an example. Giving an example is, we are trying to show good number of opportunities and challenges to the R&D team, how we can scale it up, how fund you can get it, to the policies, how government can help, and how we can implement it. Just giving few examples. For your examples, I'm telling you, personal and community hygiene, how we can improve post-COVID, and drones, unmanned aerial vehicles, how in a systematic way we can do across India, and how number of jobs we can, skilled jobs we can create, to the people. Then beyond that, there's something called more different concept, which, as Prime Minister is telling, local brand, which will make a global presence, is the banana fiber extraction. Like your silk fiber, like your cotton fiber, linen, this is another banana fiber. Okay, that I think India is a country number one under banana cultivation. Now, sooner or later, you will come to know, we are going to make a very big industry level situation wherein the full banana gold, as far as I am concerned, banana fiber extraction, and it will have tap water, make ethanol to generate So many things are possible, okay? And it can create a job, huge job opportunities can create. That I think work is almost in a very, very advanced stage. And I'm working with some of the IITs towards this, okay? IITTDM, Kanjivaram, and some of the laboratories working together. And it is some to mature stage. We are working, not only Delhi, working with the people also. This is the thing. Similarly, green effluent treatment plants. And India is now, once upon a time, was leading in textile. And now they're shrinking because of ecosystem is creating a problem there. But it calls for a green effluent treatment plants. That I think almost R&D level we have done there. So, something like that, many, many things. Even though I'm an engineer, I'm trying to advocate national drug research centers. Okay, yes, we are drug making point of India, we're leading, but research point of view, I think we are still lacking. How we can improve for that, we can do, especially post-COVID point of view, we have a large number of farmer-related employment we can create. So these are all just some of the things. This way I'm telling, one-stage students, I'm telling an opportunity. Researchers, I'm telling an opportunity. And engineers, how they can scale it up. Because some of the things are available very low level. Drones are very low level, but we are talking about few thousands of drones. Actually, every village should have one or two drones. You know, it's having more than 250,000 villages. That many drones of that capacity, a farmer should be able to operate. That level you should make it. Totally different scale. And similarly, each one of them, scale is different. For engineering has an opportunity. For that, funding has to come from entrepreneur, and the government has to clear the policies, drone operation policies. Similarly, many on each one of them. So this connectivity I'm trying to do using the webinar. And when I'm talking to your people, I'm telling this is an opportunity for you, cash on it. Okay. Each way, my English may be the same, but the tones are different and what I'm trying to convey is different. That way, now you summarize, I started from the school, and this school, I told now the playground we ourselves made, and used to pride to hoist the flag in that ground. Okay. That time I was a very small boy. I think even now also, every year, when the national flag, somewhere or other, I'm hosting, I used to believe this national flag is flying at least 1 millimeter higher than what used to fly previous year. And I used to feel on my myself, and that height, I also contributed something better. Okay. And I used to tell the people, every one of you also should feel, yes, this flag is not a national flag, just as a cloth. It is the national pride. It is our symbol. It is our symbol of when it's rising, it is pride. And that pride, I am also part of it. And that when next year it is to fly at least 1 millimeter higher than what is played today. And that 1 millimeter should have been my contribution also be part of that. I think that if you do, it doesn't matter from where you start, where you will make India the proud. Definitely we can do it. Wonder. When November 14th of 2018, when our tricolor flag landed on the moon, when Kalam was standing behind me, I think I felt that sense. Even today, every year, I'm feeling, yes, something or other, something better I have done. Maybe personally, maybe dating somebody, maybe whatever way the mood. But I think every year, inch after inch, I think definitely our national flag gets to go fly high and high and high. And towards that, every one of our contribution also be part and parcel of a nation. Not many people got the opportunity to bond. To born as an Indian, I think you should really gifted. Yes, we are all gifted people. When we gifted, we also something to give back to this nation. I think that is what we do in this nation, in this soil, for these people, for the next generation. I am doing my part. I think you also do your part. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot, sir. That was indeed a very informative session. I'm sure every member of our audience thoroughly enjoyed the lecture. And we will now begin the Q&A session with the questions asked by our live audience during the lecture. So the first question is, Gaganyaan will be India's first manned mission to space. What is the importance of this mission to the Indian space program?
Okay, yeah, look at the missions of this. For example, you talk about even your Chandrayaan or Mangalyaan or the missions of this caliber. Its direct benefits you will not be seeing directly. But it has its own implication. For example, Chandrayaan, when it came, we are able to succeed first attempt, discover water on the moon, Mangalyaan. So these are all gave a brand name for this rogue, and commercially we could do something better. And one thing. Second thing is we could attract good number of talents also back to ISRO. Otherwise, ISRO was finding it difficult to attract the people. These are all the things one side. Industry is able to grow. Now I shown now it's many good number of industries. we are able to become part and parcel of ISRO, and that's how it's coming. So Gaganyaan, you know that lot of money being invested. That money investment is happening within India. A good number of industries will succeed. These are all the fringe benefits. Beyond that, if you look at here, as I already told, after Chandrayaan 1, Moon once again being seen as totally different perspective. Okay, once again, Moon is being a different perspective, because water being available there, using that, man can stay for longer time. If he stays for longer time, something better for the back to earth, something he can bring, but possibility exists. All the things put together, there is a commercial value also coming there. When that happens, man has to go to the moon. When man is going to the moon, Indian cannot lag behind. Okay, Indian also has to go to the moon. Otherwise, next generation should not come and tell, these fellows let us down. Like that, the question Umar asked, he will not ask after 20 years later, that opportunity is not there. So first step is, one side unmanned mission goes to the moon. Unmanned mission, I think in the coming years, one second successfully land on the moon. Then subsequent attempts, unmanned mission will land and come back to the earth. In the meantime, manned mission will go to the near space and come back safely. Then marriage of these two things will happen. Unmanned mission going to the moon, manned mission going to the moon possible. That means Indian also can go to the moon from Indian soil, from Indian rocket, from Indian system can go. That will tomorrow something to be harvested. Today look at here, the amount of money India and other countries spending to have an Antarctic mission is no less than what we are going for a Gaganyaan. It's a huge, huge amount we are spending just back in Earth itself, because there are resources available. Tomorrow, when some countries are doing that resource, it's not be with one generation alone, one race alone, it should be is India also part of that we are doing. Similar thing, Moon also possible. Yes, Mars also, for various reasons, that's possible. So all things putting together, technologically also we have to acquire. And overall, our scientific thing point of view, it's a manned mission that's called for. And beyond all these things, it creates a lot of enthusiasm, triggering to the young minds to be part and parcel of the science and technology. No country can grow just with software alone. No country can grow with just the service industry alone. You have to have your science and technology to be part and parcel of your nervous system of the country progress. For that to happen, you have to enthusiasm a good number of people. To enthusiasm this helps. So like that, it has a multiple dimensions why the mission like Gaganyaan is in a place.
That's an insightful answer, sir. Thank you. So the next question is, could you tell us about your experience working and being with Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, sir?
Oh, he is a part and parcel of me, you can see that. Okay, and almost every move of mine, I think he encouraged, though I have not told in very multiple sentences, though I told ISRO. And he is a part and parcel of many of my activities beyond ISRO. Okay, and yes, within ISRO is one portion. Even within ISRO also, you look at here, Chandrayaan 1 mission, originally supposed to have go around the moon only. He was the president of India. When I presented this project report, almost all the people appreciated the project report was good. Notwithstanding that, Kalam was not really satisfied. He told, you are going all the way to the moon, falling and you're going around the moon 100 kilometer. Something you should do to make your presence felt on the moon surface. That's how we came out with another idea of 35 kg probe, which go to the moon from 100 kilometers, will throw away the 30 kg probe. That itself will contain three instruments, along with three instruments plus circular flag. Even that day in South Pole, we touched in 2008-14, when Kalam was standing behind, we have done that. And that day also, first signature of the water molecules in the so-called tenuous atmosphere of the moon, one of our probe discovered that time itself. Okay, this basic idea came from him. I think now I want to tell another thing. Kalam has written a book called Turning Point. Like whatever written Turning Point, whatever told today here, the same way, Turning Points, Kalam's life. Okay, Kalam has written. In this, one of the turning point, he has written, yes, this is the turning point. That means when I presented to him the original project report, he wanted a correction. Under this correction, I would have told no and gone ahead, but I didn't tell like that. But I went ahead that, and we have identified some way of how to do it. And that enabled people to discover water on the moon. So that he felt in spite of being a president of India, I given some technical suggestion that the team has taken it and done, and that enabled India to make its presence felt on the moon. Like that, he himself has written, okay, in his turning point book. And that's the reason, and for my way of writing, and he insisted that I should talk to the students, many things we have done. So that way, I think he's part and parcel of my life all along.
Thank you, sir. I'm sure that was a really brilliant experience for you.
Yeah.
So in the interest of time, we will be ending the Q&A session now. That was our last question.
Yeah.
So thanks a lot for that wonderful session, sir. It was a really insightful and informative talk. We once again thank you for joining us for the inaugural ceremony and lecture of Shastra Juniors 2020.
Thank you. Thank you.
I would also
My best wishes for all the organizers as well as the participants to make use of such facilities in a better way, so that will make you a turning point in your life also. I think my best wishes to all of you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I would also like to thank Dr. Nilesh Vasa and Dr. S.F. Ali for being a part of this session.
Thank you all. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
So before we end this session, I would like to share a few general instructions which are applicable for all the events, for all the participants. And finally, thank you to the audience for tuning in to watch this delightful lecture. Please do stay tuned for further events of Shastra Juniors 2020, and be sure to catch the Virtual Magic Show by Dan Rhodes at 7 p.m. on the same YouTube channel. Thank you, everyone.